Chris Redfield. Jill Valentine. Resident Evil.
Again, I'm not surprised that you're... Well, actually, not, I wouldn't say not surprised, but more like I'm just glad that you're finding these people that you know, and they remember you.
Yeah, I guess that is a loose definition of it.
It's about as loose as you can get without saying trust. To which, I actually have occasionally had people that I know online that I trust. Mm. Like, people that I know that if I met in real life, I would immediately go, yeah, I trust you. Which, by the way, you're one of them.
Thank you.
It's been one of those things that I just know all of that. Heck, you and Bo are actually on the top list of people that if I got to meet in real life, I would immediately go, dude, what's up?
Mm-hmm.
Good luck reaching me all the way down here. Especially during the summer.
I wouldn't doubt that. I'm very heat sensitive. I am sensitive to hot. That sounds so, wrong!
So you're sensitive to hotness. Is that mean you're walking?
I just walked my way right into that one and knew that I was walking into it without really knowing that I was walking into it. I'm so horrible at building... I dig my own grave most of the time, don't I?
Paul does that too. Mm-hmm. I sing him every other LP I'm in with him.
That's true.
Oh, damn it.
Damn it, you had to reload.
I forgot that I was busy reloading.
Damn it, I had to reload. Damn it, reload.
There. Considering where it was by the time it was getting up, I'm still calling that a headshot.
Yeah, because it was like, pause. Oh, wait, I have to reload.
You start taking off their heads.
Well, I did for that one.
Yeah, he did.
They need heads so when they get buried, they can put the name on the grave.
I don't know. Sometimes they just need to be nameless zombie number 50.
Now I'm really taking these dogs out like Old Yeller.
Shotgun to the face.
Gotta put you down.
Can you actually aim down and kill them at a point blank with the shotgun to the face?
You'd have to wait for them to fully get up, unfortunately, but yes, it is possible.
Wow. Now I wonder if someone has ever actually tried doing that, besides you.
Okay, I find it weird that it said that I pick up a key. Once I do, he's holding on to something.
No, he's not. You just picked up
the key. I thought the key was what he's holding on to.
Yeah, and then it's written order to the supervisors. What?
Check the guinea pig's ability
to accomplish the mission. What?
Ugh. Now I got back in my head again.
Now I feel like Jill has fallen so low on the totem pole.
That one what the hell report that just said blatantly 20 guinea pigs committed suicide the other day.
Yeah.
Which granted, once you do find the other report that actually explains what they are, fair point. But if you didn't, it's just going to make you go, what the hell? Yes, I know it's locked. Can I...
I don't need the key right now.
Don't tell me that's not the right thing. I'm just so upset. There, I feel better now.
Explosions!
Yes.
Go find the right lock you're looking for.
This is not the lock you're looking for. You want to go home and rethink about your thieving career.
You do not wish to send me sex, sir. I don't wish to say that. You'll go home and rethink it. I will go home and kill myself.
You will not be like Skip Rogers and actually find a girlfriend. I will not be like Skip Rogers and actually find a girlfriend. Move along. Move along. Move along. I would actually love to see a reaction video of what would happen if Skip Rogers did
what is that
for some reason.
What? What are those
circles
for?
It's another puzzle.
Oh, yay.
See? Puzzle!
Yay!
I already forgot the order. Yay!
Is that for down or up?
What?
Wait
a minute.
Is that how you solve? Did you solve it immediately?
No.
For some reason, I don't think that's what it should be.
Yeah, you. It's the third one from the bottom.
Yeah, it's the third one.
It's 1, 2, 3, the lower one.
The shape of the fountain changes sides of the combination of gears.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you have the one where it's the two black on the outer sides and the two white on the inside.
You want them intermixed on one side. Get all four. No, that's just...
I know.
That's the same way that you started from.
I know. That was the first combination.
Oh, yeah. To default set it? Yeah. Set it to default.
Second combo.
Yeah. To the left. That's random. Okay.
Okay.
Now,
yeah, that's the fourth one. Number four. Mm-hmm. That you had with the two white on the outside like that.
Alright, just start from right there.
Which is all four. Yay, we get to drown Jill in water.
Oh. That's what we need.
Black. To drain the pool.
Okay.
Yeah.
All black on the top, all white.
And it's black to the right.
Mm-hmm.
So, reverse that.
No.
No, hang on. White
no.
down. Click the white.
It won't let me. I already used up all the options.
Ah.
Because I only get a certain amount of movements to do.
You only get six.
Like, even that, it won't move.
Okay,
this... I'll admit, this one actually is puzzling.
It's a puzzler!
Aha!
Oh, frabjous day! No takers?
Thank you for drowning me.
No, none of us are gonna take the Mad Hatter.
Nah. And just because I can. I just wanted to start from the top.
From the top!
Nah.
It makes sense, I guess.
Ooh.
or herbs. And I don't have room.
Yeah. Or herbicides.
So, still looking at your pokey cards?
Yeah. Why?
I'm just saying.
Just wanted to start a conversation as
well.
What just happened?
Nothing. Benny, for some reason, I thought I was going to steal his cards.
I just decided to make it sound that way.
Yeah, and after my let's play of the Pokemon trading card game for Game Boy Color, I'm definitely going to steal them.
I know you won't.
Oh, yeah, you will. Because, you know, people don't cheat in card games. Yeah, just let me take a Millennium Rod, and yeah, we'll go from there.
I'll make sure you're completely screwed either way you play, Yugi boy.
Sorry.
Couldn't resist making that reference.
Well, how could you not make it?
Especially after the fact that I remember that I used that voice for Cyber Peacock in X4. Seriously. That was like I don't know why it fit Cyber Peacock, but it did.
You know, it'd be interesting if they actually were to remake X4 and give it voiceovers.
Yeah, that is a good point.
They were able to do it for Mega Man Powered Up.
Yeah, that would be an interesting thing to see them do.
Only problem is
and Maverick Hunter X, that's true. Can't forget about that.
Yeah, but unfortunately with Maverick Hunter X, they screwed up the story.
Mm-hmm.
Because Dr. King does not die in the Day of Sigma.
Yeah, that's Light.
Light was well gone before that.
Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah. Kane / Cossack doesn't die before on the Day of Sigma.
Cossack's long dead too.
Oh yeah, he is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, hell, I think even Kalinka would be dead by this point.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think it's just Wily and Kane who are still alive at that point.
No,
yeah, Wily's technically not alive.
Oh yeah,
he's still around, but
he downloaded his brain into a Skullcastle computer network and turned into an AI.
Yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm. He did.
They speculate Dr. Light did the same thing.
Which is why there are still messages from Dr. Light for X to find.
Mm-hmm. And how the castles just keep magically appearing?
Yeah.
I doubt that. The capsule network the capsules seem to me like a teleportation grid that Dr. Light has appropriated for his own use.
Yes, actually. In X Command Mission, it's actually shown that those are actually a teleportation-style platform.
Yeah.
And it's actually been used for robots all the time. So it doesn't seem unfeasible that... Or infeasible? Unfeasible? However you say not feasible.
Basically, it is not possible.
Yeah, it doesn't seem impossible for... Dr. Light to, you know, hack into an unused teleporter and repurpose it to be able to add parts to X. I mean, if he is an AI and he's taking care of his own home, then technically he has parts that he can just essentially toss into teleporters and send and replace with parts on X.
But remember, in X5, you can actually do the same thing with Zero.
Yeah, I mean, Dr. Light's probably a little freaked out that Zero is aligned with X now, because the popular theory is that Wily sicked Zero on Dr. Light's lab and he killed everyone in there.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah.
He trusts him enough at this point to hand over the armor parts and get them to X.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, it's probably because he's realized that Zero's become more than just a pawn
Maverick
of Wily.
Yeah.
I mean, Zero is the progenitor of the Maverick virus. Well, it's not the Sigma virus, it's the Maverick
virus. Wow, nice snake dodge.
Or the Zero virus, if you prefer.
It started as a
I'd say after getting raped by Nemesis so much, especially with Form 2. She's gotten used to it.
Sigma had Sigma
anything
had
tentacle style will she'll dodge.
How appropriate. For once, we face zombies that actually unearth from the ground.
Or were hiding in a pile of grass.
What was that again?
I don't know. The viruses of X.
Yeah.
It's basically a style, it's the Maverick virus that Sigma got from Zero.
Well, it's virus C's, if you want to say plural of virus.
But basically
it works on the same word way as the word asterisks, which is asterisks.
Either way, it started out as the Maverick virus, the Zero gave the Sigma, then it became the Sigma virus, which then became the Zero virus.
Yeah, because Zero appropriated it for his own use. Or rather, it just came back to him.
Came back to him.
Okay, where was I again?
Somewhere.
Over the rainbow?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, viruses. Yeah. Basically, Zero was the original carrier of the virus that created Sigma, and he figured that one out in X5, which is why he spread himself all across the globe, because he wanted to infect enough Reploids that he could replicate the Zero virus and hopefully wake Zero up.
Yes.
In fact, Zero virus corruption does horrible things to X, Zero becomes invincible.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To the point where if you normally get infected with X, it actually restores your health as Zero.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, because he's getting infected with his own original coding.
All it's doing is just giving him back health. Yeah, I think they're just in piles of leaves.
Ooh. Double kill.
Next, we're just going to see you do a triple kill.
Kill-tacular.
Multi-kill.
Then we can say he's officially gotten all the different achievements. Zombies killed in 1, 2, 3.
Killing spree.
And of course, then we can't forget that later on in X8, Mavericks can just go Maverick at will.
Actually, they were doing that in X7. Technically.
Technically, then you can say it was doing the same thing in 4. With the Repo Form. They
weren't going Maverick on their own. They were actually...
They were going
for a specific purpose. They weren't actually trying to include humans in their worldview.
But, by Maverick was going against what the humans wanted. Hence, they were going Maverick.
Well, again... As the general put it, this is not about insurrection nor rebellion against our human creators, but...
They just wanted to take this giant space colony that had provided to them by Sigma and leave Earth.
Yeah, they wanted to leave Earth. They didn't want to stay on the planet. They wanted to leave Earth, leave it to the humans, so that the humans could go back to the way that they were before they were dependent on the robots.
Which would never happen.
Yeah, it wound up never happening.
Because, we built you, you listened to us.
Not to mention Sigma was playing both sides.
Yeah, he was.
Well, of course.
It's Sigma.
Because he knew darn right the humans are going to do everything.
And by X3, he had already met Wily.
Yeah.
It's implied in his dying words that in X3 that he has already met Wily, because he calls Zero the last of the Doctor's creations. By X3, he's already met Wily in the form of Esoc or some other shell.
Well, is that Gunpowder C?
Yep.
Okay, good. I was just wondering because you probably wanted freeze rounds.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that thing is... In X3, we're not even aware of who made Zero.
Yeah, speaking of freeze rounds.
And then definitely in X4, when we see the flashback where it's Zero versus Sigma, and it's like, yeah, now we know who made Zero.
Wait, I just realized something.
On his head gem.
Oh, yeah.
GM?
Yeah?
Kyurem is called the Boundary Pokemon.
Okay.
The what?
Boundary Pokemon.
I hear boundary, but I can't hear the second word.
Pokemon.
Pokemon.
Oh.
Yeah, Kyurem is called the Boundary Pokemon. What would happen if you wound up fusing together, basically making an unholy fusion of Kyurem and, Yukari?
Yukari wouldn't mate with a Kyurem.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying mate. I mean, as in, like, you know, fusion. You know, fusion, ha?
Oh,
geez.
She would adopt one as a pet.
Again, I can definitely see her taking one as a pet, definitely. But I mean, I can only imagine what would happen if she fused her powers together with Kyurem.
I'd be more worried about if she did it with either Dialga or Palkia.
Well, Dialga and Palkia aren't actually capable of fusion.
Well, but they
Palkia,
are.
Palkia, wait. No, I'd be more worried if Sakuya got a hold of Dialga.
Master of time and space, made mistress of time and space, or of time, not space, because actually,
she has some space manipulation.
She has some space manipulation, but not a lot. It's basically just large enough to allow knives.
Well, I mean, the Scarlet Devil Mansion is a tesseract, much bigger on the inside than the outside.
There so it's a TARDIS.
Who could have done that? Sakuya or Patchouli?
Patchouli. It's much easier for you to use magic to make something bigger on the inside than it is for you to use time and space. Much easier. That and also, if you use magic, you can also make magical ley lines indentured into the extra-dimensional space and allow you to be able to essentially heal and or, you know, slowly return your health if you were starting to bleed out of it.
Not to mention the fact that the ley lines would probably reinforce the spell.
Exactly. Hence why I would say Patchouli probably was the one who made the mansion bigger on the inside. Basically, made the mansion the tesseract that it is. It would also reinforce the fact that Patchouli doesn't really have the capability to completely tap into her own ley lines anymore.
Well, the problem is her health is just so bad.
Yeah, it's just so bad that even the healing power of the ley lines won't help her. There is a way to deteriorate your health beyond the capacity of what even a magical ley line can heal. Which definitely says really bad things for Patchouli. But again, Pokemon paired with Toho characters.
Well, when you think about it, Pokemon's paired up with Nobunaga's ambition.
Yeah, they are. Mm-hmm.
So,
which is Samurai Warriors, right?
Yes. Roughly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Nobunaga's ambition is essentially Samurai Warriors. But yeah, Oh, great. Now all I can think of is, Now all I can think of is Marissa Kirisame with a Gyarados. Can we say Hyper Beam Colored Master Spark?
The Dragon God Ryujin combined with Arceus.
Actually, I could see that happening. Especially since Arceus can become a dragon type.
Yep, just give it the dragon plate.
Yeah.
Never mind that both characters are like the deities of their respective settings.
Yeah. Even though we have, what was it? even though we have, like, so many such close-to deities in the Pokemon universe. Oh, God, I just imagined, what was it, Yuka with Sunflora.
Since they don't know much Toho, so...
She would grow those things, I think.
Oh, okay. Let's see. Sunkern and Sunflora.
Yes.
I can just imagine Yuka with an army of Sunflora that know, what was it? Solar Beam.
Better than raising victory bells that eat you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, you want to capture one of Yuka's Pokemon? Have a nice death.
That's what I was thinking! Yuka would create a giant field of Sunflora, and people would try to catch him.
Like I said, you want to take something that belongs to Yuka? Is your name Marissa? It's not?
Then die.
Nice death. Flippin' idiot.
Yes.
Because Mima and Yuka were BFFs in the PC98 era. Marissa is not the only person that Yuka respects.
And maybe even considers a slight friend.
Yeah.
If not like a begrudging ally.
Kind of like a niece. Almost.
Yeah.
So where is that key you're looking for?
I have no idea. Key, key, key. Who's got the key? Oh, yeah. By the way, GM, did you see Nakatilili's Let's Play of Kirby 64?
I was waiting for him to finish the thing up, so I'm going to have a look at it now.
It's finished now.
Yeah,
just letting you know.
I'm actually liking his behind-the-scenes on his Minecraft.
Yeah, the behind-the-scenes is really awesome.
Yeah, I mean, I remember when that second-to-last video came out, my statement, I still stand by my statement that I made when he posted that video. The Nakatilili I know would not have given up like this. The Nakatilili I know bent space-time over a table to kill Porky Minch.
Yes. I mean, it definitely did feel that way to me, too. That Naka wasn't really being Naka. And I guess he also admitted at the same point that, yes, it didn't really feel like his own thing. And I guess it's when the return to form happens.
A bad taste in everyone's mouths.
Yeah. And really, actually, to me, that actually may have been needed. I actually feel like that actually may have been necessary to help drive the plot a little bit. Mainly because, not because a hero always falls, but because there's always a dark time where they don't think of themselves as they are. And any hero worth their salt will come back from that and realize, I am me. And will completely face the opponent.
Despite going completely insane and BSOD, I think at the very end it was like a total red ring of death, not just a blue screen, a red ring.
Yeah, the thing that you usually don't. James Otter?
James Otto.
Oh, Otto. Otto!
No! Awesome bus driver!
Don't you know you have to get into the zone? Auto zone! Alfred.
Cones. Well, there goes a cone head.
Yep. Belmer. No, wait, sorry. Dan Aykroyd was a good cone head!
Dan Aykroyd. Yes. Also did a great job as a Ghostbuster.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of which, I managed to kill 10 ghosts in Guild Wars 2, so I got the Ghostbuster thing.
You got the Ghostbuster achievement unlocked?
Ghostbuster!
Yeah, kill 100.
No, just 10.
Just 10?
It's just 10 for that one.
Really?
Yeah.
Didn't know that.
Oh, yeah, because you have a 10... 100, 500.
Windows blowing in from the fireplace?
And I think maybe 1,000 kills for the next one above that
I'm going to be so upset right now if that's all I had to do.